Today I've got a workout for you that is designed using two different exercises, and we're just gonna alternate back and forth between each exercise. So let me explain. We're gonna organize this workout in an EMOM fashion. EMOM stands for every minute on the minute. So I'm gonna set a timer for 10 minutes, and at every minute, I am gonna complete a certain number of repetitions of each exercise. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna alternate each set between exercises. So we'll get 5 sets of one exercise, 5 sets of another exercise. So let me talk to you about the two exercises we are gonna be using. Now, the exercises we are gonna be using are both combination moves. They're huge, big bang exercises, gonna work a ton of muscle groups in each movement, okay? And we wanna make sure that we can perform them with correct technique. So, the first exercise is going to be a dumbbell push-up plus a renegade row. This is gonna be a big upper body exercise with the push-ups, meaning front of the shoulders, the chest, the triceps, and then we're gonna get a lot of core stability and with that rowing, as well as some lats and posterior back shoulders, all that. So to do this exercise, we need a set of dumbbells. I like to set them up here so they point inward a little bit, puts the shoulder at a pretty favorable position. And what we're gonna do is, we're just going to position like a push-up, so wrist under shoulders. I'm going to push up, no head jutting forward, and then rowing each one without allowing the hips to swing or sway. So you may need to start with wide grip feet, just to give you a little bit more stability, and then you can narrow up the feet as you get more stable, okay? So that's the renegade row push-up combination. The next combination is going to be a dumbbell bent over row with an RDL. So this is gonna work the posterior part of the body, hamstrings, glutes, spinal erectors, upper back, everything, and then arms, shoulders, lats as we row, all right? So to begin, we just need another set of dumbbells. I'm gonna stand with feet hip width apart. I'm gonna push those hips back, keeping that neutral spine. I'm gonna row, I like that little twisting movement. Down, then stand up. So from the side, I'm gonna keep that neutral spine, I'm gonna push those hips back. I'm gonna row, squeezing those shoulder blades, control it down and up. So that are the two moves. That is the two moves. Grammar, I'm a trainer, not a linguist. So those are our two exercises. We're gonna set a timer for 10 minutes. All right, so I've got a timer set for 10 minutes. I'm gonna call out the repetitions as we go. We could, as we go on, manipulate the repetitions to change the workout. You guys can feel free to do that, but let's just follow along with this workout as we've got it and see how it feels. You can always take it up from there. So I've got my water as well. We're gonna need it. It's 10 minutes of work. It's a short workout, but these are big exercises. So the top of the minute, we're gonna start with the push-up plus the renegade row. We're gonna do 5 reps for that first minute. So let's go ahead and get into place. Get your dumbbells set. And we are ready, we're set. We're gonna be up and we're gonna do 5. So start with your push-up, push-up, row, row. Push-up, row, row. This is number 3. Keep that head still. No drooping hips. This is number 4. And that's number 5, all right? Now you could use one set of dumbbells. You may find, like in that RDL bent over row, I'm gonna be a lot stronger in that. So I've got another set there that's a little heavier. We're gonna keep it at 5 as we go to the bent over row RDL. Keep things simple. We're gonna work a lot of muscle groups here. Minute 2 is coming up. We're gonna get 5. I'm in position, we're going in 10 seconds. Feet in position, hands to the front of the thighs. Ready, let's hinge it over. We're doing 5, up and squeeze, down, up. Making sure we're keeping that neutral spine. We've got 3. We've got 4, and we've got five. No big deal so far. You may find one exercise is way easier. So for me, I could be going up and up and up on that neck, on that bent over row RDL. Our back's a lot stronger. Obviously that renegade row, there's a lot of core stability going on. But we're gonna go six. We're gonna up the ante. We're gonna go up one repetition. In 20 seconds, we're gonna go right back down to renegade row. We're gonna go for six of these. I'm gonna show you from the side on this one. We're gonna get set in that position. Going in about 5 seconds. So everyone up into that plank, we got six repetitions. Let's begin. Now you can make the workout. You can move really fast and use lighter weight. You'll get that heart rate zinging, although you might with just this. I know mine is. This is four. Keep that spinal stability, no twisting. Keep that head set. I don't want those hips dropping. And there's six. All right, we've got six. We're up just under 30 seconds. We're gonna take this up to six as well. So if you want more of a heart rate effect on this, use a lighter weight. Try upping the amount of repetitions. That'll reduce the amount of rest you have. We've got about 10 seconds left. And my heart rate's going up a little bit right here. We're going in five, get set. I'm gonna show you from the side. We've got six, hinge it over, row squeeze. There's one, two, control that weight. Three, four, five, and six. All right. And as I said, make the adjustment to the weights as you need. That's only six reps. We've done four total sets of 10. What do you say we take it up to seven? I'm feeling pretty good. A lot of ways to organize this workout. You could just manipulate repetitions, climb up to high repetitions, back down the ladder. You could keep it the same. You could make progress by tracking, seeing what weights or repetitions you can accomplish, and go from there. We got 5 seconds. We're gonna go seven repetitions. Ready, set, let's go. One, two, three, stay with me, four, five, six, stay with me, don't get sloppy. And seven, nice work. Hope you're with me, under 30 seconds. Gonna go seven right here. We're halfway through. So I hope you can appreciate how this kind of workout is very effective, very fast. We're going in 15 seconds. It's obviously hard to do and talk. Maybe I should just be quiet. Nah, that's no fun, 5 seconds. Get set, we're going for sevens. Ready? Hinge it over, let's go. Squeeze those shoulder blades. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Good, finish strong. Now, you might be saying, hey Brad, we're doing two rows in here. Don't we want to be balanced? We do, but most of us need more pulling to balance our posture, to keep us from folding over, that position of driving, sitting in a desk, we want to ride it. So a lot of rowing is beneficial. So we got about 10 seconds. What do you think about eight? Let's try taking it through eight. We're going to be on set seven right here. Going for eight, get set. I'm not gonna talk much. Let's go, eight. One. There's two. Three.
Halfway, that's 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. Excellent. Whew. Only about 25 seconds left. We're gonna go 8 on the bent over row RDLs. Whew. That's working for me. We got 15 seconds. Get ready. Maybe time for some water. Grab those dumbbells. Let's get set. Ready. We're doing 8. There's 1. Squeeze, keep tight. 2. Push those hips back. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. And 8. Great work. Okay, so we've only got 1 more set of each exercise up. I say we keep the intensity up. Let's go for 9. Big finish. We're going to do 9 renegade rows, adding that push-up first, then 9 RDL bent over rows. Whew, let's get going. 9 of these, we've climbed every single set. Each group, we've gone up 1 repetition, so our rest is decreasing. Let's get set for our renegade rows. Push up, 9 repetitions. Let's go. Keep stable. There's 2. 3. 4. No swaying hips. 5. 6. 7. 8, 1 more. And there's 9, excellent, okay. We've only got about 20 seconds left. Big finish here. I'm gonna get 1 more drink of water. Woo, 15 seconds. Whew. 10 seconds. Last set, grab those dumbbells. We're gonna do 9. RDL bent over row. Get those feet set. Let's go. 9. Squeeze. Don't break that form. 3. Squeezing those blades. Come on. 4. Controlling that weight. 6. Come on. 7. 8. 9. Whew, let's do a bonus one. 10, why not? Round number. Squeeze. Up. Whew. All right. Good workout. That was your 10-minute EMOM. 2 combination moves. We've worked everything pretty much head to toe. Hope you enjoyed the workout. Until I see you next time, have a great day.